I surveyed 100 people to see what they wanted most in 2022, and the top two answers were more resources to get started with IoT and more ways to back up their data. This was followed by an end of the pandemic and world peace. Unfortunately, we won't tackle those last two in this episode, but you better believe we're gonna knock the first two out of the park. But wait, you might be saying, who is this guy? Well, my name is David Tucker, and I was the host of Cloud Tracker for Pluralsight. And now that Pluralsight and ACG are coming together, you'll be seeing me here periodically giving you the Azure updates you crave. But don't worry, Lars will be back next week. Oh, and while you're here, if you want to keep up to date with this Azure news, hit the subscribe button below. On to the news. Microsoft has made a big push this week in the overall developer experience for IoT Central. First up, Microsoft had launched a new GitHub repository cataloging resources that can help you get started with your IoT Central solution. This repository can be your bookmark for getting access to code samples in a variety of languages, architectural guidance, sample applications that leverage the IoT Central APIs, and helpful utilities like the Azure IoT CLI extension. Now, you can grab a link to this repository in the description. Now, in addition to this, Microsoft has also provided additional resources in the documentation to help people get started with IoT Central. If you have a connected device solution on the horizon, these resources should make getting started a little bit easier. Next, are you keen to start your cloud journey? If you scan the QR code on the screen or click the link in the description, you can get 40% off all of our personal annual plans. This will give you access to all of our courses and great features like hands-on labs and practice exams, making it easier to kickstart your cloud career. You've got until March 11th. Next up, do you remember that time you left a perfectly functioning data center to head off on a week-long vacation to Tahiti, only to come back and discover that ransomware has effectively taken down your painstakingly curated collection of cat videos? Really, it's happened to all of us at some point. Thankfully, Azure Site Recovery is now able to solve this problem for you, as they have extended the time you can hold on to recovery points from 72 hours to 15 days. That means you can sip a few more drinks on the beach without having to worry about needed recovery points sailing away beyond the horizon. In addition, Azure Site Recovery's recent updates include a lot of additional goodies, including additional replication options, expanded Linux support, and the ability to leverage zone redundant storage disks when replicating Azure VMs. If you play a critical role in planning your organization's disaster recovery plans, you'll want to review these features to see how you can take advantage of these new capabilities. Finally, I've got some good news and some bad news. The good news is that Microsoft is making it easier to leverage persistent volumes in your Azure Kubernetes Service workloads with AKS Persistent Volume Backup. With this new AKS capability, you can backup and restore application data stored in a persistent volume. Now, you might be saying, that's great news. How can there be a bad side to this? Well, the bad news is that this is only available in a private preview, so you'll have to request entry into the preview. However, if you look on the bright side, I don't expect it to be too long before this ends up in a public preview so that everyone can try this out. Whatever your hopes and dreams are for 2022, I hope that these Azure updates get you a step closer. If you have any comments or questions at all, let us know in the comments. Seek and you shall cloud. See you next week, and keep being awesome, cloud gurus.